The Lightspeed Zulu 3 is Lightspeed's flagship ANR headset, but is it worth the premium price tag?
We are about to stall,
and this is our adventures in and around South Africa.
What's up guys, my name is Carl and the headset I have here is one of the two most compared top of the line headsets in aviation, and for good reason. With its great build quality, comfort, sound quality, features and of course noise cancelling capabilities, you can see why any pilot would want to upgrade. A quick disclaimer, I was not sent this headset and definitely not paid to make this video, but I wanted to share my genuine impression and experience with owning and using it. So if you like this video and find it useful in your decision making, please consider subscribing and hit the bell notification for alerts to future videos. Let's talk about the build and comfort. It features two nice and big faux leather ear seals housed in magnesium ear cups. The ear seals have very comfortable memory foam type cushions. That's wider where it makes most contact, spreading out the pressure for more comfortable fit. Speaking about the pressure, the Zulu 3 has slightly less side pressure than the original Zulu for increased comfort over extended flight, while still maintaining a good soundproof fit. The headband is made of a stainless steel band and notched extender with soft touch plastic trimmings. Something I found interesting about my head is that my ears are positioned in such a way that I prefer to have basically any over-ear headset to be on the shortest extend setting. And this plays a big role on comfort and fit. What I found with the Zulu 3 is that although it makes a great seal around my ears, it does sit a little bit farther down than I prefer and can actually cause some of the air to leak in if I eat something while flying or turn my head. I also wear spectacles when I don't use contact lenses, and although they fit pretty well, it does leak air quite a bit if you wear glasses. Another thing to look out for is that the soft touch plastic trimmings can show signs of wear pretty quickly if manhandled a bit, and that's where the really nice hard shell carrying case comes in. It's shaped in such a way that it's really easy to get the headset in and out, especially with the cable placement, and even has a pouch to keep your license. One of my absolute favorite build features has to be this cable. The Kevlar braided cable is honestly something I wish all headsets have. It's really durable and does not tangle, unlike basically all other headset cables I've used before. It's a huge hassle saver. Sound quality is as expected. Radio communications come through clear and crisp, and the microphone is really good. What you might not know is that the microphone sensitivity is actually adjustable. It's very useful in extremely noisy cockpits like our Crystal Eagle. The microphone does, however, only stay on one side of the headset and cannot be reversed. And of course, the active noise reduction. The Zulu 3 is definitely the best when it comes to Lightspeed's headset lineup, and you can clearly hear the difference. But how much of a difference does the ANR make? Okay, so we're at Heidelberg Airfield where we hang the Crystal Eagle. And as mentioned earlier, she has a really noisy cockpit, making the perfect test bed for noise cancelling headsets.
Okay, so the first test I'm going to do is just take an ambient cockpit noise recording so you can hear what it's like. Okay, and I've now placed the microphone inside my ear so you can hear what it sounds like without noise reduction. And now this is what it sounds like with noise reduction on. Whoa, that's quite a difference.
So as you can see, the noise reduction actually makes a huge difference, and it's really worth it if you ask me. Some extra features include a Bluetooth connectivity to your phone for listening to music or taking a quick phone call. It's obviously not made for everyday music listening. The quality is decent, but the person on the other side of the phone call can definitely tell that you're using a headset. One of Lightspeed's Bluetooth features is the comm priority, and you may like it or not. When you listen to music and a radio transmission comes through, it dims your music to prioritize the radio call. When the radio gets busy, this can be annoying, but you're not supposed to be listening to music anyways. And yes, I have actually used the headset for long commutes as well. One thing that I did find is that some of the headsets have a very tinny Bluetooth sound, and that's also something to consider. But when using the wired auxiliary input, it seems to get rid of it. Another extra feature is Lightspeed's FlightLink app that allows you to record audio from your headset to your phone. However, it seems to only record your voice and not the rest of the audio from the radio. Lightspeed's customer service is outstanding, and we've had some actual experience dealing with them, and the communication and service quality was great. We have a video about it, and you can find that in the cards above or in the description. One last little quirk that we discovered is in some aircraft with some radios, particularly my father's Kitfox with a Garmin radio, if you plug the Lightspeed into the passenger headphone jack, it goes haywire and makes a screaming noise. But plugged into the pilot side, no issue. The Zulu 3 has an advertised battery life of about 40 hours, and although it's difficult to measure, it does seem fairly accurate depending on how you're using the Bluetooth features. If you do run out of battery though, you can still use the headset, but without noise reduction and with significantly lower volume output. And last but certainly not least is the price. At $850, it's not cheap, but very competitive compared to its biggest competitor, the Bose A20. So, is it worth it? Let me put it this way. Ever since I started flying, I've been very conscious of my hearing, turning down the volume of my music and using hearing protection in noisy environments. So I'm a firm believer in using a good quality headset while flying, because you cannot replace your ears. That being said, during my training I did not own my own headset. I borrowed Rian's Bose A20 for a while and used headsets that the flight school had. So if you are a student that doesn't quite have $850 to spend, you can look into Lightspeed's more affordable Sierra headset, or my recommendation is to get a good quality pressure fit headset like a David Clark for your training, and then upgrade a bit later. If you are a person that does a lot of flying though, I would seriously consider the Zulu 3. It's worth saving up and investing in the well-being of your hearing. If you want to know if it's worth saving up even a bit more, you can check out our comparison video between the Lightspeed Zulu 3 and the Bose A20. It will be linked in the cards and in the description once it's live. This has been my honest thoughts and review of the Lightspeed Zulu 3. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up and please consider subscribing. Let me know which headset you currently have and what you think of the Zulu 3, or if you want us to check out any other aviation tech. Until then, dream big, fly high, and live the adventure.